Let's look at some adding subtracting questions for rational expressions that are slightly more complicated. Up till now, we've been dealing with ones that have a denominator that were monomials. Now, we're going to start with this first one here where our denominators are binomials. We've got m minus 2 here and m minus 2 in our denominators. Question m minus 4 over m minus 2, subtracting m minus 10 over m minus 2. Even though these are both binomials, we have common denominators, so we can treat this just like a regular addition problem or subtraction problem here. So, our denominator carries straight across, and we just work right across the top. M minus 4, I'm going to write this in brackets here, you'll see why in a sec, subtracting m minus 10. Now that we've got this over our common denominator, all we have to work with now is the numerator, and we're left with basically a problem that is addition or subtraction of polynomials. M minus 4 minus m minus 10. So let's rewrite this without the brackets. Again, the denominator stays the same, m minus 4, and because we're subtracting this binomial here, we're going to flip the sign of each term inside. So this positive m becomes a negative m, and this negative 10 becomes positive 10. And we can just simplify the numerator. We've got m minus m, so those are going to get subtracted to 0, and we've got negative 4 plus 10, it's going to give us 6 over our denominator m minus 2. That's as far as we can go with this. Let's look at the next question. 5 over x plus 6x over x plus 4. Here we don't have common denominators, but we can treat this exactly the same way we were working with monomial denominators. Only the algebra gets a little more complex. Our lowest common denominator, we're going to be able to find here is actually going to be the product of all the factors that we have in our denominator. We've got one denominator, one factor in that denominator, another factor here. This is made up of two terms, but only one factor. There's only one thing, basically, here that we can multiply with. So our lowest common denominator is just going to be these two factors put together, x plus 4. Once I've identified what those are, I know what I need to multiply each of our terms here by in order to get that common denominator. I've got x here, so I need to multiply this guy by x plus 4. And again, whatever I do to the bottom, I have to do to the top. And this one has x plus 4, so I need to multiply this by x. Now, when I rewrite this, I'm going to have 5 times x plus 4 over x times x plus 4 plus 6x squared, multiplying the 6x and the x, over x plus 4. Draw a line here just to keep that separate. So now we can do our addition. Basically, we've got common denominators. We should put them in brackets to be consistent there. So putting the whole thing over x plus 4, we've got 5x plus 4 plus 6x squared. And I always want to try to write my highest power terms at the front, so I'm actually just going to multiply this one out. If you left your answer in this case, it would still technically be correct, but for proper form, we will multiply this out and we'll write our highest power term of x in front. So that's going to become 6x squared. Distribute the 5 here, we're going to get 5x 20. And I'm just going to leave my denominator in factored form. If you expanded that out again, that's okay. That's as far as we can go with that one. Let's try one more. All right. So here we've got 7 over 2x plus 4 minus 5 over 3x plus 6. You know, we always want to find our lowest common denominator here. Lowest being the keyword. Excuse me. So you might look at these and think that our lowest common denominator would be 2x plus 4 times 3x plus 6. That is a common denominator, but that's not the lowest one. In order to find the lowest one, we need to factor our denominators first. So to factor 2x plus 4, we have a common factor of 2, which we can pull over there, and we're going to have 2 times x plus 2. And to factor 3x plus 6, I'm going to factor out a 3 and be left with x plus 2. Now, we look at our lowest common denominator, the product of all the different factors we have. We have 2, 3, and x plus 2 in both there. So our lowest common denominator is actually going to be 2 times 3 times x plus 2 or 6 x plus 2. So now I've got a lowest common denominator that's a little easier to work with. In order to get this as a denominator of 6x plus 2, I'm going to multiply it by 3, top and bottom, and here by 2, top and bottom. Excuse me again. So now we're going to multiply this out. 7 times 3 gives us 21, over 6x plus 2, multiplying the 2 and the 3 there, leaving that factor the same. And 5 times 2 gives us 10. 3 times 2 is 6, x plus 2. Now, I've got a common denominator in both. I can rewrite this as 21 minus 10, which is 11 over 6, x plus 2. And there's nothing else we can simplify or factor out, so we're done with that one there.